The National Broadcasting Company invites you to listen to Glenn Miller's music.
Hello and welcome to another edition of Glenn Miller Music. I'm your host, Barry Papernick. So nice to have you with us. This is a program dedicated to the big band era and the music of Glenn Miller from 1938 to 1944. Some great music and some great memories. So if you're ready, let's come out swinging.
Jump in it is your fancy. We got one coming up that's specially designed for your listening pleasure. String of Pearls. It's written by one of our arrangers, Jerry Gray. It's one of our latest recordings. And I think you'd enjoy listening for Bobby Hackett's cornet later on in the piece.
Thank you. Thank you.
Glenn Miller Radio, heard round the world.
This is your swinging station.
Hutton sings, "Ooh, what you said."
Ooh, what you said got me all flustered, face is red. Oh, what you said when you said what you said. Ooh, what you did got me all bashful like a kid. Oh, what you did when you did what you did. Fun is fun, but look at what you've done. Ain't you the naughty one? Talking that way, say, are you joking or just outspoken? Ooh, what you said ought to go cover up my head when you whispered I love you. Ooh, what you said.
We borrowed Larry Clinton's Dipsy Doodle.
Thank you.
the blues.
Yes, another great Glenn Miller medley. Something old, something new, something borrowed, and something blue. Before that, we heard the St. Louis Blues, a great 1939 live version. Prior to that, a little I Got Rhythm, a Billy May arrangement, live from the Café Rouge in New York City, January 1st, 1942. We heard Glenn himself introduce a little Bobby Hackett coronet with String of Pearls, and we kicked off our set with Anchors Away from Hollywood as the band began filming Orchestra Wives. That's from March 25th, 1942, as you enjoy the music of Glenn Miller. Right here on Glenn Miller Music, I'm Barry Papernick. Good to have you with us. Right now, we want to go to that man in the romance department. It was Ray Everly's job to slow it down a little bit. And here's a great one from Ray.
Thank you. Romantics, Ray Everly and the Modern Airs to double up on that grand tune, I Hear a Rhapsody. And if I know anything about my right combinations, this is it.
And when I hear you call so softly to me, I don't hear a call at all. I hear a rhapsody.
And when your sparkling eyes are smiling at me,
then soft through the starlit skies, I hear.
So blue when you're away.
My heart longs for you, so won't you stay?
My darling, hold me tight and whisper to me.
Then
some great romantic music from the Glenn Miller Orchestra. We just heard Ray and the Modern Airs, I Hear a Rhapsody, from a broadcast of January 30th, 1941. Before that, a song that was never actually recorded by the band in the studio, but we have that version of My Buddy, which was recorded from a broadcast in New York at the Café Rouge, a Chesterfield broadcast from August 19th, 1942. And we started the set with Ray singing Indian Summer, a little different than the recorded version. That version we heard, Indian Summer, was recorded at the Meadowbrook on the 24th of November, 1939, and some great trumpet solo, which we don't hear on the recorded studio version, some great trumpet solo by Johnny Best, three in a row from the Glenn Miller Romance Department, right here. With Glenn Miller Music, I'm Barry Papernick. So nice to have you aboard. I want to go now into the Miller Music memory bag, a little bit of a story with Ray Anthony. You know, Ray is still with us. A lot of people ask, are there any members of the Glenn Miller Band still alive? And yes, as of this date, Ray Anthony's still alive, living well, loving life out there in Southern California at age 94. He appeared not that long ago. He actually played with his band at his 90th birthday party. But the question that people seem to ask most about Ray Anthony, was he actually fired by Glenn Miller, and was he actually fired twice? And we're going to hear in this audio soundbite from Ray himself from an interview back in 2008.
The Glenn Miller people heard about me and came after me to audition for his band. I don't know if you remember Bullets Durgan. He's the one that came out to the Flatbush Theater in Brooklyn and pretended he knew me. Because, you know, stealing a musician from one band to another wasn't the proper thing to do at the time. I had to go back. I had a contract with Al Donahue. I had to go back and get out of the contract. And Miller didn't think I could do it, and so he hired Billy May. So I came back, told him I'm ready to go. So the way it wound up, Billy and I joined the Glenn Miller Band the same week, 1940. And then we went on, and Glenn Miller fired me after about 3 months, and the band went to my hometown, Cleveland, to play at the Palace Theater. And whoever he replaced me with didn't hold up too well, so his manager at the time, Johnny O'Leary, came over and asked me to if I wanted to rejoin the band. That was, you know, the high point of my career, since my career was music. So I said, yeah, of course. They were on their way to Hollywood to make a movie, Sun Valley Serenade. So I rejoined the band. It lasted another year or so, maybe a year and a half, and he fired me again. And nobody... including Paul Tanner and some of the guys. Nobody would tell me if they knew exactly why I was fired. I was cocky, and in my mind, I was overly enthusiastic. Here I am, there's an 18-year-old punk kid at the top of the music world. So anyway, that's my history with the Glenn Miller Band.
So you never did actually find officially out why?
Never did. Paul says I was a cocky kid. I mean, that's the way they interpreted, you know. It's like you wouldn't do anything on purpose to jeopardize your position. So it was something that I didn't think anybody was, it was important for anybody to think about it. Well, I got fired, you know. It's my, one of my claims is that I got fired from Glenn Miller's band twice. People like to tease me about that.
Remember, you heard it. Probably that's to it. A long time ago. Now's your chance to relive it with Living Radio.
Especially for the boys in what might be called the new Fightin' 69. These boys, pretty much from around New York way, are now in Anniston, Alabama at Fort McClellan. They were among the first to leave in service for our country. And boys, by now, I guess you know what this title means. Miss Hutton, give them the 5 o'clock whistle.
We'll be working all night long.
All Coast Guard, the best, the west.
whistle? Won't somebody fix the whistle? Oh, who's gonna fix the whistle?
So my poor old papa, no, it's time for him to stop. He walked to hear what my mommy said. My papa came home and sneaked into bed. Told her he worked till 2:30. The 5 o'clock whistle never blew.
Just bought a place down by the Bakers, a little ranch with 1,000 acres.
Daddy! I want a brand new car, champagne, caviar. Daddy!
Daddy! You ought to get the best for me, Daddy.
Yes, the whole gang got in on that one of the novelty tunes the band was famous for. The whole gang, Marion Tex and the Modern Airs on Daddy from a Chesterfield broadcast in New York City, September 3rd, 1941. Before that, Glenn himself introducing Marion, or Miss Hutton as he called her, with the 5 o'clock whistle, December 5th of 1940. And we started our set, Keep an Eye on Your Heart. That was Marion Hutton, again from a Chesterfield show at the Café Rouge in New York City. That was January 1st, New Year's Day, 1941. As we listened to some Glenn Miller music, so nice to have you with us. I'm Barry Papernick. And now we want to turn to the band some people just can't get enough of. And we're so lucky to have so many great recordings from the Glenn Miller Army Air Force Band. So if you're ready, let's buckle up, because we're flying home.
Machine. It's so easy to say pet names when you listen to the trumpet of Harry James.
We love to hear that tenor croon whenever the ink spots sing a tune. If I didn't know why the roses grow, then I wouldn't know why the roses grow.
Honey child, if I didn't know all the little things I'm supposed to know, then I sure wouldn't be one of them there ink spots.
If I didn't know.
Bo, 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 bo.
Along the Santa Fe Trail.
little bit of a different arrangement there of along the Santa Fe Trail. You'll remember that from the civilian band, but that was the whole shebang with an orchestra and strings with Johnny Desmond's version, recorded on the 18th of December, 1943, along the Santa Fe Trail. Before that, a little jukebox Saturday night with the Crew Chiefs from a broadcast of February 18th of 1944 in New York City. And we kicked off that set flying home. A little Bobby Nichols in there on the trumpet, Peanuts Hucko on the clarinet, and a gentleman named Louis Stein. This is a pre-Mel Powell doing some great tickling of the ivories there, flying home. The Army Air Force Band right here as we listen to the music and the memories of Glenn Miller. Good to have you aboard. I'm Barry Papernick. And now we're going to turn back the clock. We're going to make it showtime. Pretend your radio's on. It's October the 18th. 1940, you're tuned to the National Broadcasting Company, NBC, and Glenn's program sounded like this from the Café Rouge in New York City.
Glenn Miller's music gives the proper background now to Ray Everly, who comes forth in song with a handful of stars.
Recall the story, that night of love and glory, a night that left my heart romantic scars. We stood so near to heaven that I reached clear to heaven and gathered you a handful of stars. Sweet remembered hour when love began to flower, with moonlight through the trees like silver bars. And as the moon grew older, I reached across your shoulder and gathered you a handful of stars. I placed my fingertips upon your lips and stars fell in your eyes. Moon glow made a halo of your hair. Things unspoken trembled in the air. Our hearts were madly beating, and then our lips were meeting, and Venus seemed to melt right into Mars. Then while we stood caressing, blue heaven sent a blessing, a shower of a handful of stars.
Go for it. Glenn Miller's orchestra goes to it and hammers out the rhythmic beat of the Anvil Chorus. Thank you. Glenn Miller and his orchestra play the anvil chorus with Maurice Pirtle on the drum set. And now, according to the Bureau of Standards, it's 1 out of 7. But Marion Hutton and Tex Beneke come to the point in saying the gentleman needs a shave.
He's renowned for his savoir-faire. A glance from him makes the girls happy, and his smile has them walking on air. As he strolls down the avenue daily, all the feminine hearts start to thrill. But somehow today, I'm sorry to say, the gentleman's charm is nil. The gentleman's clothes are smart, gentleman's all the rage. He set for love from hat to glove, but the gentleman needs a shave. The gentleman has technique, the gentleman's quite a name. He's mighty smooth and in the groove, but the gentleman needs a shave. It may be none of my business, but here's the point to the song. You just can't start to break a heart with whiskey 3 feet long. If the gentleman wants the love the gentleman seems to crave, he'd better hop to the barber shop, 'cause the gentleman needs a shave. How come you're looking so brought down today?
Well, my romance is headed straight for the grave, 'cause my gal won't kiss me until I shave. She says prickly pears are pick for pickles. There ain't no peach picks a fan at prickles.
Well, man, you're due for a once-over light.
Well, get out the barbershop. There ain't none in sight.
Well, shave or no shave, I want to hear you too.
All right.
I don't mind that beard. On you, it looks cute.
Aye, so long it gets under my feet.
Well, climb out of that hayloft and let's get on the beat.
On the beat, though.
Playing of the slumber song, we write beauty. This program of dance music played for your dancing and listening pleasure by Glenn Miller and his famed orchestra, the dance sensation of the nation, from the Cafe Rouge of the Hotel Pennsylvania in New York City.
This is the National Broadcasting Company.
And that's the way it sounded, October the 18th, 1940. The band was live in front of an audience at the Café Rouge in New York City at the Hotel Pennsylvania. A great broadcast heard on the airwaves of NBC. I hope you've enjoyed spending some time with us today. I know we've enjoyed it, the music of Glenn Miller. Some of the early days, some of the Army Air Force Band, and a radio show to close things out. And a little tidbit there about Ray Anthony's career with the band. Thank you so much for joining us. Until the next time, have a moonlight serenade.
NBC has invited you to listen to Glenn Miller's music. Sweeter Swing is styled by the swing exponent of the trombone and one of America's ace arrangers, Glenn Miller. And until another time real soon, good night.